Samantha Jo in Washington. One of the biggest takeaways on the question of obstruction of justice, the Mueller team is constrained by the legal situation here, the department policy that they cannot indict a sitting president. And they make it very clear here that they are going to abide by that department policy. Now, right in this report, the special counsel quotes here, they explain, if we had confidence after a thorough investigation of the facts that the president clearly did not commit obstruction of justice, we would so state. Based on the facts and the applicable legal standards, however, we are unable to reach that judgment. Now, from that point on, they lay out a pretty detailed episodes, essentially times where the president was putting pressure on current and former officials in his administration to do things that maybe they refused to do or felt uncomfortable doing. Specifically mentioned the case of former White House counsel Don McGahn, when the president asked him to fire the special counsel. Also mentioned former Attorney General Jeff Sessions, where the president had asked him to get involved in the special counsel's investigation, even though he had already recused himself. So the big question is, why did the special counsel go through all of this evidence to then essentially punt that decision on the question of obstruction of justice over to the Attorney General, who is a figure appointed by the president? Well, the special counsel clearly talks about why it's so important to document everything, have everything when memories are fresh, have clear evidence. And then later in the report, it says, if Congress should so decide, if they should be able to rule on the question of justice, of obstruction of justice, they should be able to have that opportunity as a co-equal branch of government. So very interesting stuff here. We'll continue to keep digging, bringing you more very soon. Reporting live on Capitol Hill, Samantha Jo Roth, Spectrum News.